Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today's video is going to be a special video because I've been looking into making controllers work with the DDS, which does not natively support controllers, so you basically can't play with the controller. And if you want to play with the controller, now's the time that you can just do it by watching the video and getting to know how to do that. So for this video, you will need a controller. If you want to play with a controller, you probably have a controller already. So yeah, you must have a controller. You can also use a PS4 controller, I'm pretty sure. And the second thing you will need is Steam. That's how you're gonna play the game anyway. So yeah, so once you get your controller, you want to plug it in first, then open Steam, go to your library, right click on DDS properties, then go to controller. This is not a native support for controller, so this is probably the closest you can get to a controller experience without actually having the game to support it. Then you have to click this button. Once you click it, this will pop up. Then you want to make sure there's the controller that you have is checked. For my case, it's an Xbox 360 controller, so I check that box. Then you can just close it. Once you are done, just close that window as well, and click this button to open big picture mode for Steam. This thing will pop up, and you will be in this menu, which you can already start using your controller like this. Then just navigate to DDS, click it, then make sure you're on that left menu, manage the game, go right, controller configuration and controller options. These are what we're going after. So first time you go to controller options and make sure this is going to global setting, which is Xbox, and make sure your controller preference is set to on. Also make sure you press OK for first time. We go to up to controller configuration, click it, then here we can configure the controller itself. I have a French layout keyboard, which means the keys for me are somewhat different, like the movement keys. I don't use WASD, so you have to set up your own configuration, or you can just browse my. So I will share it with this name, and I will leave a link in the description so you don't have to look for it, just find it, that link. Then go back and play the game. Just open it, make sure you still have your controller plugged in, of course. Once you get into the game, you can already start using the controller to play the game, and I'm fugitive mode, so I just have to navigate to the clothes wardrobe, and yeah, I'm good. You can sprint by clicking or holding the left stick that allows you to move. You can jump, crouch with the by clicking the right stick. You can get your phone out with X or the triangle for PlayStation, and if you click it, it opens up your menu. You use the right buttons and left buttons to also do that stuff. My configuration has that the right trigger will is mouse one or left mouse click, and the left one is the right click. So you can apply mixes and stuff. And the left stick is becomes a scroll wheel to navigate this menu, which is not very efficient, so you still might need the keyboard and mouse to make the mixes. And yeah, that's the weakest point of this controller setup or configuration. So yeah, Hope you guys enjoyed the video again. Make sure to hit the like button if this was useful, and subscribe if you like my content or want more. And have a good one.